Hi, welcome to show 51.
Yes, this is our second year.
Yes, we have firmly moved into the second year. Thanks everybody who watched last week. As of filming, loads of people have, so thanks to our man, Mr. SD, for popping around and getting behind it so much. Well done, mate.
Honestly, the amount of stuff that had to be cut out of that was unbelievable, because he is filthy, I'm telling you.
Filthy, filthy man.
Filthy man.
But he's a nice man.
But we love him. We love him.
Yeah. This week, we've just me and Chris. We've got nine cracking tracks for you, though. Yeah, so
We do try.
Yeah, back to 15 minutes. This is fresh from someone's act today.
It is. Yep, I went around somebody's house and purchased their jazz collection, and this was in between it. It was quite nice. Cedar Walton. And it's called Mobius, and the track here is called Off Minor, and it is.
Yeah, and it's a Theo Monk track.
Yeah.
But it's nice and sharp. It sounds like it was like produced today.
Yeah, nice, heavy, snappy drums in it and stuff. So yeah, wicked. But we're gonna go as per usual. We try and sort of like mix it up a little bit. So we've got a right broad spectrum of stuff this going on this week.
Yeah, you'll be surprised by a couple of those tracks.
Well, we hope so.
Yeah. Cool.
Is that a break? Yes, it was. Anyway, from this rather lovely slab, we're going to go to this.
We don't usually pay much off comps unless the stuff is really expensive and rare.
And this is really expensive and rare, but this is a classic, nice little bit of UK psychedelia. Yeah, this is a Skip Bifferty, Oh Love, a cracky little tune. Lovingly comped by those lovely chaps at Bam Caruso on Rubble 8, All the Colours of Darkness. Freaky, man.
I mean, the comp itself is 22 years old now, so
yeah.
Maybe that's worth saying as well.
Maybe.
Hard to find.
Maybe.
A nice tune.
Very nice tune. Very British.
Yeah.
His American psychedelic stuff is different than English psychedelic stuff, and then they come from a different sort of angle, you know what I mean? It's almost like Motorhead, isn't it? It's wicked. Anyway.
Very nice.
Yeah, this one creeps in quietly. A bit like Brad.
When SD was sleeping in my spare room.
Yeah.
He didn't know I was there.
Yeah, he was walking like John Wayne the next day. Yeah. Wicked tune, wicked this is.
Yeah, this is Smith.
Yeah.
Gal.
Yeah, it's basically this song is called I'll Hold Out My Hand, and it's
Gal
on this album. Yeah, a bit like a funkier Jefferson Airplane. Yeah, anyway, this one we picked up at Notting Hill Musical Video Exchange. There's a running theme here, really. It's pretty local to us, so that's why we go there. But for the princely sum of £5, you can still get some cracking stuff.
Smith, as you can tell, are a West Coast American band.
Yep.
Apparently they only had one album, but they didn't.
Because I've got two.
Anyway, you read it as one album, they're one.
Yeah, both albums are really good, so they're well worth picking up. There's a good, like, five or six good funky rock tracks on there with nice drums and stuff.
It had a big hit with Baby and Shoes.
Which is also a great track.
Yeah.
Yeah, so after this nice bit of funkiness, we're going to go to a bit of soul. And I have to thank Mr. Thing for this one, because I got it off of him in a trade a few months ago. So thank you, Mark. What a tune.
Lovely tune. This is Trouble by Brendan Wood.
Trouble.
And as Chris said, this came from the sack of Mr. Thing.
He emptied it.
He emptied it.
And I had to have it. Gobbled it up, I did.
Trouble from the man is probably the least trouble in the world.
Yeah.
Better be careful.
It's just so good, so good.
No, I really care and I love you so. But if you do me wrong, then I'll be gone in the morning.
It's one of those tracks that can end up on your film or end up on a comp.
So you better change your ways and change your mind now, baby.
Yeah, it's brilliant. I'd never heard it before we played it to me, and I was like, I've got to have it. So This is the 7 on Double Shot Records. Go out and find it.
Yeah, so
next up, we're really going to turn this on our head because we've got Madge coming into the shed.
That's right. My favourite, if anyone was watching last week.
Yeah, that's right. It's because of what we found out about Brad last week that we are actually playing this next track.
It's not true.
It is true, come on.
It was Chris in my dressing gown.
Brad's actually got jerry curls under that. That's why he had the shower cap on.
Yeah, I've got a big ass, bro.
Anyway, from Brendan Woods.
Make it to the end of last week's session episode, doesn't have a clue what we're on about.
No, that's all right. But anyway, you better watch it, don't you? Anyway, so from Brenton Wood, we're getting to Madonna. Here we go. Yeah, not any old Madonna track.
No,
we couldn't do that to you.
Because we don't like her. But
yeah.
This is Erotica. It's the B-boy mix.
The B-boy mix by Kenny Dope and Louis Vega. So yeah, there's the 12. I got it in Oxfam for 99p, so that's my excuse. But it is wicked. It's good. Come on, let's start. No.
Yeah. It does get going. There you go.
What you can't see is that I've actually got cone tits on under it.
He does have cone tits. What's your favourite Madonna look?
Madonna look?
Yeah, well, of all the Madonnas.
All the genital Madonnas?
Yeah, all the genital what? Madonnas.
I don't know, probably the Like a Virgin, I guess.
Like a Virgin's the best.
Because
she's pretty ropey, but she looks quite slutty in that, in a sort of young, sort of slutty way. Yeah. When she got older and started to be a bit more sophisticated, she became too manly.
Yeah, well she was, even in that film Body of Evidence with Willem Dafoe. She was pretty ropey in that, and that's a good 20 years old. Candle wax on the nipples. Anyway, she's obviously good something because so many people have bought her tunes. But anyway, but this is wicked. So there you go. There's an instrumental of it as well that keeps the B-boys happy. Yeah.
Speed it up a little.
Yeah. Anyway, after this, it has come to our attention. And this time last year, we did give a rest in peace to MCA from the Beastie Boys, who passed away a year ago.
Yeah.
So in honour of the great man, we are going to play another Beastie Boys track. So from Madonna to MCA. Here we go. With the added bonus that it's a Jimmy Smith sample. That's why Brad's got a big, huge grin on his face.
Yeah, this is Root Down. May the 4th, MCA Day.
Yeah.
So.
Quality.
Can't go wrong with the Beastie Boys, are
you? No, you can't.
SD from last week will be smashing out some Beastie Boy tunes on Saturday, so, or would have been on Saturday, that's it.
I'm sure his body moving.
Yeah, the Jimmy Smith album, Root Down was only done live, and it goes for about £8, something like that, a one hour. So,
I ain't got it. I've got it on a comp, but I haven't got the original.
Yeah, I've got an immense amount of Jimmy Smith albums, but I haven't got that.
I picked up a few Jimmy Smith albums tonight, didn't I?
You did, mate, you did. One came my way. Yeah, nice tune.
Yeah, wicked. Yeah, so after this we're going to go into a bit of Funk 45 Fury and then a theme that you are never going to forget and you will remember from your childhood as well, depending on your age of course.
If you're young like us you will.
Yeah, if you're youngsters like us.
Whippersnappers. Or just whippers.
Yeah.
Our third take of this. Keep muddling our words. This is Dennis Coffey.
Fucking Coffey. Anyway, this is Dennis Coffey, Wild Child on Westbound Records, nice little 7. About 3 different sort of breaks in it, very much the sort of breaks that would have been sampled around about the late 90s by sort of like, you know, the break sort of DJs and stuff like that. very nice as well. Not quite as funky as his earlier stuff, because it's a bit later, but it's still wicked and still some nice drums.
Yeah, it was nearly our break of the week, and obviously because it's got a couple of nice breaks in it, so
yeah,
you hear a little bit of that, you know.
But we've got a special B-boy break to put on after this. Very, very well known, but really well worth it.
Just a chat about, obviously we were busy filming our one episode with SD last week. Just what we missed, just after we finished that, the guys at Breaking Bread brought up the radio show that we happily and willingly featured on, which was 2 hours of soundtracks by us two and our man Skeg from Breaking Bread.
That's right, yeah.
And Skeg. And
he cooks a mean salmon.
He does cook a mean salmon. Yeah, it's cracking. It's gone down a storm. It was a hot crowd cast and everything. You can download it on iTunes. Even my missus is listening to it. But yeah, so we'll put the details up right here.
Check it out.
Yeah, it is really good. Not to blow our own trumpet. We have to try and blow ourselves, but
I did. I nearly broke my neck.
Yeah, that's true. But yeah, it's cracking. Like this tune.
Yeah.
Also went to the Breaking Bread night at the Bell. That was cracking as well. Put on three parties.
First three parties.
Just for the love of it. Nice guys, man.
That's right.
Steve the Sleeve.
Hello,
yeah.
Mate.
Yeah.
Right, so from that breakbeat fest to this one.
We love a hoedown in the shed.
We do like a hoedown in the shed.
If we can get her right in amongst the records.
Yeah. Might be a few stuck in the corner still. Yeah, this is Bad Bassoon, Black Grass, and this is the original US 45 of this magical, funky country track on Paramount Records. Wicked. Many of you might remember that Hip Hop Street History. There's a bit where like some B-boys were breaking of this being sort of cut up and stuff. I think it was that genius of wherever it was. But wicked, really, really cool. Wicked drums, sampled by everybody on one of the Ultimate Breaks and Beats albums, but hey, it's a classic, so here we go.
It is great. Chris is wearing the appropriate shirt.
Howdy, cowpokes.
I'm just wearing my fashion mag.
Yeah, I do either look like a blood from LA or some, bum raper. Me and Brad would do-si-do, but honestly, you couldn't swing a cat in here if you wanted to.
Every week it just gets more packed.
I know. I have to do something about that.
I keep my rooms tidy.
I can't.
He can't. He just got fast, didn't he?
Here comes the brakes. Yeah, now, so from some serious breakbeat business to some very silly theme music. So to lead us out of this crumbling shed, we've got a special theme just for you.
Yeah.
Can you guess what it is yet?
We like a amusing theme. If anyone listened to our mix last week, we stepped Animal House in it, but this is even crazier than that.
That's right. I'm just going to get the gift aid sticker off of this. I bet you still don't know what it is, do you?
Doozers watching. We sometimes do like a jokey one.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
Yeah, couldn't resist this one. Anyway, that is enough from us this week. So there was 8 quality tracks and this. But there you go.
Our first dud. But it's fun. Thanks for watching. We've got a couple of good guests lined up actually coming soon.
We do. But I don't want to say it just in case it jinxes it. But I have got to actually get in contact with the man tonight because I forgot to. So, but yes, over the next couple of weeks there's going to be another couple of people coming in the sheds.
Yeah, and as always, we've got bundles and bundles of good records to play. We've literally got piles of stuff that we've had to say, no, not this week, next week, not this next week. And some wacky stuff arrived from the boat today and been dug out. So we still have attached onto the stuff we've got at record store day, so.
Oh, Christ, yeah. All right.
Yeah. Cool. There you go. Thanks for watching. See you next week.
See you later.
All I ever wanted, all I ever needed
was here in my arms.
Yeah, that's good, man.